I thought I'd do another cookery video, seeing as my rabbit stew one went down so well. This time, if you for all those who get Airgun Shooter, in the March edition, Matt Manning, who whose articles I enjoy very much, decided to do pigeon pasties. Well, as a full-blooded Cornishman, I've got to give this a go, haven't I? So I've assembled my ingredients, and we're going to make our own pastry, and then we're going to make the pasties from scratch, basically. So, what we need, 8 ounces of plain flour, 4 ounces of butter, Rodders, Cornish butter. I only use Cornish butter in Cornish pasties. Breast from 2 wood pigeons. Well, luckily I managed to get out yesterday. It's the first time I've been out for a long time, and I managed to get 2 wood pigeons, so as soon as I picked up the second one, I thought, right, I'm making those pasties this week. 3 potatoes, 2 carrots, an onion, and some swede, a beef stock cube, and a bottle of beer. And as you can see, I am so famous, I have a beer named after me, so I had to use that one. So basically, we're going to make the pastry up first. My sister taught me a simple rule years ago about making pastry. Half fat to flour, so we've got 8 ounces of plain flour there. So we need 4 ounces of the butter. And there's no need for me to film making pastry. We all know how to make pastry. Well, there we are though. There's my ball of pastry. Now I'm going to follow the recipe exactly as Matt wrote it down here, because I think that's only fair on him. So in the top of there he talks about making a pastry, which we've just done, and now we've got a place to finish pastry in a plastic bag and leave in the fridge for 30 minutes to recover and cool. So while I'm doing that, while that's recovering, then I'll just start on the vegetables. Right, now I've come across a bit of a problem already. It says here, I want to follow this recipe as Matt has written it down. It says here, peel and finely dice the onion, potatoes, carrots and swede. Well, that's not the way my mother does it. So I'm going to have to get some confirmation here that it's alright to do this in a pasty. Hang on a minute, I'm going to phone a friend. Alright, Colonel King, yeah, hang off here. What's on? Yeah, look, I'm making these pigeon pasties. Yeah, pigeon, I know, it's all a bit Heston Blumenthal, isn't it? Yeah, well, anyways, it says here, I gotta peel and finely dice the vegetables. Well, that ain't the way mother does it. You think that's alright, do we? Yeah. Alright, Birdie. Alright. Yeah, I'll be at Dogging Club on Wednesday. Up Chasewater? Alright, well, I'll bring a couple of these pigeon pasties, see what you think. Alright, mate. Yep, cheers and gone. Right then. So, we've cut the pigeon breast up and just rolled it in some flour. And we've got all our veg chopped up there. Look. So according to the instructions now, we got to brown the pigeon chunks, after which they can be removed from the heat and set aside, and then throw in the vegetables and cook, stirring occasionally over a gentle heat for 5 minutes. So we'll better get on with that then, and we'll throw off this pigeon a minute, just until it's brown, and then we can bung that veg in. Oh yeah, we've got a knob of butter in there, because you've got to cook with butter, haven't you? I've only got this on a gentle heat at the minute because I just want to brown these off. Right, so there we are, we got the pigeon on the go. So I'll brown that off and stick it on this plate to cool off. And then I'm going to have to do all these vegetables for 5 minutes. So I'll come back when the veggies are in and they're all softened up. Right, well, these have been in here for about 5 minutes now. So we've got to add a cupful of the beer and sprinkle the stock cube and chop herbs over the top and stir while cooking for another 5 minutes until the vegetables are soft and the beer has reduced to a stiff gravy. So let's get this beer on the go then, the famous Angoff, and a bit for the chef. So I'm going to throw the stock cube in now and simmer that for another 5 minutes. Okay, so we're nearly finished now, really. There's the vegetables in their beery gravy, and the pigeon all cooled off. And according to the instructions, you roll out the pastry until it's 3 mil thick. Oh, I don't know how you measure that. and then use a plate or a bowl as a guide. Cut out the circles around 20 centimetres in diameter. Well, there's my plate I used, which was 23 centimetres. I think that's near enough. And then you spoon a generous helping of the filling into each circle. Obviously, you've scattered the pigeon over it. And then brush around the edges with beaten egg and crimp firmly shut. I've done one here already, look. And then I'll give it a good eggy wash afterwards. And don't forget to put a hole in to let the steam out, otherwise it'll just all explode everywhere. So I'll get this other one made, and then they go in the oven for 20 minutes at 200 degrees. Right, well, the oven's up to temperature now. We're up to 200 degrees. So these little beauties are going to go in for 20 minutes. And then we'll see if all this hard work's been worth it then. Big thanks to Matt Manning for coming up with this recipe. It's certainly given me something to do this evening. So 20 minutes, grab a beer, bit of Motorhead on in the other room, and pigeon pasty for tea. Lovely job. See you when they're ready, bees. Well, there you go. We're out of the oven and we're looking very nice. I've just got to wait for Mrs. Goff to get here now, and then that's going to be our tea. So always worth picking up a copy of Airgun Shooter, Matt Manning. Always some nice hunting articles, and some good recipes as well. So there you go, it comes out every month.